Hey everyone, welcome back to Psychology of Rock. If you're new here, my name's Nina, and today we are talking all about the psychological benefits of being a music person. And by this I mean someone who doesn't just listen to music, but values it deeply and connects with it on a level that the rest of the world probably can't even understand. Because believe it or not, according to research, it not only changes our brain in a very positive way, it may actually be one of the best things for us and about us. So if you've ever been told you are too obsessed with music or you take it too seriously, this video will be full validation that science is on your side. As usual, you can find the citations for all of the studies that I used to make this video in the description box, just in case you want to read them for yourself. But I also want to talk a little bit about my own experience, because music has been a huge priority in my life for as long as I can remember. And I can say with certainty that it has 100% changed my life for the better. And I know I'm not alone in this. In fact, one of my absolute favorite things in life is being able to connect with other music people, even if it's just for like 5 minutes in line when I'm at the grocery store and I see someone with a band shirt that I like, or responding to the comment section in this channel. I've always just felt there is something special about people who relate so strongly to music and seem to almost live for it. The people who can immediately list off the albums that got them through high school and all of the concerts and the artists that changed their lives completely. I've always felt this kind of unspoken bond with them because music has always literally felt like oxygen to me. It's gotten me through the worst times of my life and made the best parts of my life even better. I grew up in the punk scene and later gravitated more towards rock and metal, but I spent almost every weekend going to shows and every hour I could find listening to albums and trying to learn my favorite songs on guitar, and whenever possible, hanging out with other people who had the same passion I did because they were the only people that seemed to truly understand me. But lately I've been thinking about how rare this type of connection really has become and how odd it is that we're in this world where there has never been more music available, yet people seem to care about it so much less. It's not that the songs aren't there, they're everywhere, but the way people engage with music has definitely changed to the point where, for the most part, it seems to just be more background noise now instead of something to get lost in or help people make sense of the world around them. And to me, that just feels like a huge loss because for people like us, music is not just sound. It is tied to everything from identity to emotion. And in my experience, and according to a vast amount of psychological research, people who live that way, who engage deeply with music, are actually better off. And when I say this, I don't mean that they are better than anyone else, because that is completely subjective, but according to science, they are better equipped emotionally, mentally, and even neurologically. So let's go ahead and unpack that. Why music people have it right, and how turning back to music can literally make our lives better. But before we dive in, I want to quickly mention that while the visuals in this video will most certainly be paying tribute to the bands and the artists that have shaped my life the most over the years, which tend to be in the genres of rock, metal, alternative, and punk, because that is my musical taste, it's important to note that the benefits that come from being a music person certainly aren't specific to these genres. It's just my preference, hence the channel name. But whatever music you love is going to affect your brain in exactly the same way. So let's start with something that I think is honestly pretty mind-blowing, and that is the fact that listening to music lights up almost every single brain region at once. MRI studies have shown that when we listen to the music we love, our auditory cortex, motor cortex, limbic system, and even our prefrontal cortex all start firing in sync. That is incredibly rare. Most activities activate one or maybe two parts of the brain, but music is like a full brain workout, emotional, physical, and cognitive all at once. And that's part of the reason why music people often report feeling things more deeply. We are literally more neurologically engaged. When we hear a song we like, our brain releases dopamine, the same chemical that is involved in reward, love, and motivation. In fact, one study out of McGill University found that listening to our favorite music releases just as much dopamine as eating our favorite food or falling in love. And it doesn't even stop there. Music also triggers the release of oxytocin, the bonding hormone, the same one we release when we hug someone or share real moments of emotional connection. I think that's one of the reasons why concerts can feel so euphoric and communal. We're not just hearing the same sounds, we're chemically synchronizing with the people around us. It's part of what makes the unspoken bond between music people that I was talking about earlier so real. But even beyond chemistry, I also want to talk about emotional intelligence, because this is an area where research consistently shows that people who engage heavily with music tend to score way higher. Studies have found that people who spend more time listening to and analyzing music are better at identifying and labeling emotions, both in themselves and in others. Essentially, we just become a lot more emotionally literate, even when the songs that we're listening to don't seem to be conventionally emotional on the surface. This can lead to healthier relationships, better decision making, greater resilience, and overall improved well-being. Now, another fascinating finding is that big music fans also tend to have stronger memory networks. A 2019 study showed that people who engage heavily with music have higher connectivity between the hippocampus, which handles memory, and the prefrontal cortex, which handles planning and reasoning. That's why music is so deeply tied to memory. As we've all experienced, a singular song can pull us right back into a specific moment in time, complete with all of the emotions that came with it. That shows that this phenomenon is not just nostalgia, it's actually neuroscience. But let's go a little deeper now into the psychological side, because music doesn't just reflect emotion, it also helps to regulate it. Research in music therapy and psychology consistently show that people who turn to music to process emotions are better at emotional regulation overall. They're less likely to suppress what they feel and much more likely to find constructive ways to express it. For example, when we listen to sad music when we're sad or angry music when we're angry, it's cathartic. It actually helps our brain process these complex feelings and allows our brain to complete the emotional cycle instead of bottling everything up. And this finding might be one of the main reasons why music people do tend to be a lot more resilient. When life falls apart, we have something to turn to that's grounding and familiar and emotionally honest. Music gives structure to chaos. It translates the unexplainable into something that we can feel our way through. But something else that I found interesting was how music affects the default mode network. This is the part of the brain that is involved in self-reflection and identity. A 2021 study found that music people show more stable and integrated self-concepts. In other words, they have a stronger sense of who they are. That might explain why many of us feel like our musical identity is core to our personality, because it goes beyond just preference. It's part of how our brain actually organizes meaning. So when we say things like "that song saved my life" or "that band raised me," we're not really exaggerating, because our brain has literally built part of our sense of self around these sounds. But in addition to all this, there's also a social piece. Being a music person does tend to come with higher social connectedness, even for people who identify as introverts. If we think about things like concerts, fan communities, record stores, or even online comment sections like this one, we can see that music provides a shared language. We can walk into a room filled with complete strangers at a show and instantly feel a sense of belonging. And I think that's part of the reason why the shift that we talked about earlier feels so strange, where people are now just kind of viewing music more as background noise. I mean, when you strip away engagement, you lose all of these benefits. The emotional regulation, the connection, the sense of identity. You lose the very thing that makes music such a powerful force in the first place. But even on top of all of this, there's also growing evidence that deep engagement with music starts to literally protect our brain over time. Older adults who listen actively have better cognitive flexibility, memory retention, and even stronger immune responses. In fact, research in neuroscience actually suggests that lifelong musical engagement can delay cognitive decline and even help rebuild neural pathways after trauma or injury. This is something that has come up again and again in the comment section where people have shared their experience of how listening to music has helped them to improve their cognition, especially after a stroke. And if this is something that you're interested in a full video about, please let me know in the comments. But again, to be clear, these benefits don't come from just having music on somewhere in the background. They come from engaging with it, from listening closely, feeling it, discussing it, playing it, and allowing it to be part of our story. And I really think that's what sets music people apart from everyone else in the first place. We don't just consume music, we actually participate in it. And that participation, by the way, can have huge benefits for our mental health as well. People who engage deeply with music report lower levels of anxiety and depression, higher levels of life satisfaction, and even greater empathy and creativity. In fact, studies have found that frequent music engagement is linked to increased psychological wellness across every demographic studied, regardless of age, genre, or background. So when we talk about music people, we're really talking about people who have learned, consciously or not, to use sound as a form of emotional and psychological self-care. And honestly, as I said earlier, it really does seem like we are doing something right. But anyway, as always, I would love to hear your thoughts on this, so please leave them in the comment section down below. I love connecting with you and hearing your stories and your musical influences. It is such a big part of why I have this channel to begin with. I want to thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you have not done so already, and I will see you in the next video.